Did you know that there are actually characters in the original Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare that aren't in the sequel, Garden Warfare 2? Well, if you didn't, welcome to the video! What's up, guys, and welcome to Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare. And today, we're going to be talking exactly just that. There are four different characters in the original Garden Warfare 1 that aren't in Garden Warfare 2. And I'm going to be talking about those characters, going to be playing them a little bit today, and talking about why they actually aren't in Garden Warfare 2. Now, some of them have been remade into different characters in Garden Warfare 2, but these characters, as they originally are not in Garden Warfare 2. So I thought it would be really cool to make a video on this. And why I am is because I know a lot of you actually got Garden Warfare 2 for Christmas, and a lot of you have been telling me you're new to the game, you've never played Garden Warfare 1, and what is it like, all that kind of stuff. So I figured I'd make a video on this because I'm pretty sure a lot of you don't actually know about it. So we're gonna be trying it today, seeing how it works out, but let's actually go over the four characters that you cannot play if you are only a Garden Warfare 2 character. And that is, first off, the Berry Shooter, which is honestly probably one of my favorite pea shooters of all time, and I'll be talking about some characters that are similar to him as we play with him in game. But this is the Berry Shooter. We also have the Chester Chomper, which he probably looks similar to a certain brand name character that you are familiar with. Once again, we'll talk about all of their similarities and the why they exist once we actually get to playing, but this is the Chester Chomper. We also have the Citrus Cactus, which, once again, one of my favorite cactus characters as well. And then we only have one zombie that is the Dr. Chester, which of course is pretty darn similar to the Chester Chomper in design. But those are the four characters we'll be going over today, so I hope you guys enjoy it as we play with, I guess, some Team Vanquish would make for a good fit. So let's go ahead and get started with that. All right then, so we're starting the plant side, so we'll go ahead and get started with the Berry Shooter, which is probably my favorite pea shooter in Garden Warfare 1. So that's actually a pretty darn good start. Hello, Mr. Chomper, but this guy is actually very commonly compared to the Rock Pea in Garden Warfare 2, and that's just because they actually are pretty darn similar. I would say that the Rock Pea does have some differences, though. He moves a little slower. I think he does have a little bit more health. He might have 125. It's hard to say off the top of my head, but this guy, what he does is he mostly focuses on splash damage, but if you are able to land the direct hit, you can see you get massive 28 damage hits. I mean, sometimes more. It looks like I hit 35 there. So you can hit a lot of damage on these people. So make sure that you're trying to land the hits. But if you don't, if you hit that splash damage, you're still in, you know, in the good set of things here, because you can just do a lot of damage. And that's sort of the thing. What you're trading with that, of course, is a slower fire rate and I think less ammo. So it's definitely a different pea shooter, but he's a lot of fun to play. And he honestly was overpowered for a good while, and I think they actually ended up nerfing him because of that. But he's still pretty darn awesome. And you guys might be wondering then, why is this character not in Garden Warfare 2? Well, the Berry Shooter and the character we'll be playing later, the Citrus Cactus, were actually added as a promotional campaign, which what that means is it was actually promoting a real-life product, which was some kind of flavored water called, like, Aquafina something something. Basically, the whole idea was if you, like, you know, it was just basically like, oh, you get these two free characters and they're sponsored by Aquafina and, you know, you should go and buy Aquafina, blah, blah, blah. You know, it was just sort of some sponsored thing that probably gave PopCap and EA more money just to, you know, keep making the game. So that's what really the idea was. But because of that, there's something called licensing. You can't really recreate characters like that that have that specific licensing that are tied to another product like Aquafina without actually, you know, setting up more licensing with a second game. And that's why these characters and the Chester characters aren't in Garden Warfare 2, just because they didn't want to pay for those royalties for those licensing again. So what is easier to do instead of that is just to recreate the characters, but with, you know, original non-copyrighted setups like the Rock Pea. You know, nobody can own a rock, you know, but they can own the berries and like the, like, okay, they don't own the berries, but you know what I mean, there is like a sort of licensing to it. Obviously, they're also not making any monetary gain by transferring that specific character over. You know, this character only existed to make them more money off the, you know, the promotional campaign. So to make this character again, it doesn't make them money, so they instead just made the Rock Pea. And that's really the idea with all four of these characters, is that all four of these characters are from promotional campaigns that just did not transfer over for obvious reasons. And that's sort of the thing. Garden Warfare 1 actually had more promotional campaigns than Garden Warfare 2 has. I think Garden Warfare 2 has only had one promotional campaign. It was for some yogurt, but instead of getting a full-on character, yet alone four of them, we actually just got like a 5-minute mini quest that was like, go through these rings. You know, it was like a little time trial, which was like way at the beginning of the game's launch, and we've never seen one since, from my knowledge, unless I'm forgetting something. So they've definitely changed their ways in some ways. But the update that the berry shooter came in, like I said, was the same update as the citrus cactus. And I'm trying to know like all of my stuff for this episode, so I hope you guys enjoy it. It's a little bit different, but the citrus cactus and the berry shooter came in the what update was it? It was the Tactical Taco DLC update, which also was the launch of the map we're playing right now, which is a funny coincidence, the Jewel Junction map. And also, it was the launch of the first ever Vanquish Confirmed game mode, which is my favorite game mode. Oh, the double there, insanely good. I like that, I like that. Now let's sit up here and see if I can't damage you. Oh no, I think you spot me. Come on, just take him out before I get taken out. Come on, you better run. You better run. Where is he gonna go? I don't know, so I'm gonna damage somebody else in the meantime. All right, I'm gonna go and hunt him down if I can. Wait, he's right there. He's right there. Ooh, I'm gonna miss it. Oh, nope, I missed that one. Oh, I missed that one. I'm so bad. I'm so very bad at this game. Come on, come on. Oh boy, here. Oh gosh, there you go, there you go, there you go. Gotcha, okay, so I got that one. But yeah, so the update that this guy came in was a very, very cool update, so I enjoyed it a lot. All right, there we go. All right then, so we're about halfway through this round, so I'm gonna quickly switch over to the citrus cactus. Now, the citrus cactus has actually not been remade in any way in Garden Warfare 2. So this cactus is similar to the Super Commando Soldier, where if you press shoot, it actually fires a triple round. Now, that's also similar to the Popscorn in Garden Warfare 2. So they haven't recreated this character specifically, but obviously this character's design has been shown in other variants on the Soldier and the Kernel Corn. I would really, really like to see a citrus cactus style cactus show up. Obviously, it also doesn't make too much sense because why would there be a citrus cactus if there's now a citron? Like, wait, what? Like, it doesn't make too much sense, but, and obviously that's because, you know, citron didn't really, you know, wasn't really thought of, I don't think, at this point when Garden Warfare 1, you know, was first coming out and this character came out and everything. But yeah, there is not a triple shot cactus in Garden Warfare 2, so I would really like that to change. We probably shouldn't be playing with this if we're trying to show off this part of the character. But yeah, you get the idea. It's really, really cool, though. It's one of my favorite cactuses. I don't play with it too much, but if you can get some decent accuracy, you can actually do really, really well with her. I mean, the fire cactus is still the best. You know, hands down, not even an argument, but this is still a very awesome character. I can do some damage. It's 15 damage for like a headshot on an engineer like this, and we can just take him out nice and easy peasy. Unfortunately, our team is like totally losing so far. I wish that could change, but yeah, these two characters were added in the same update, so it's just cool that they have that connection. And they're, of course, part of the same promotional campaign. So that's sort of the idea with it, of course. But yeah, if you guys have had Garden Warfare 1, what did you think about these promotional characters? Did you ever end up playing them? Now, the Chester characters that we'll be playing next round were actually very peculiar in many ways, so I can't wait to show them off and talk about, like, sort of the story behind them. But yeah, that's sort of the idea. The zombies are sort of taking over at this moment. But like I said, I wanted to sort of check this out and talk about this for the very particular reason that, what's it called? They're not in Garden Warfare 2, and chances are they will never be in Garden Warfare 2, at least in the form that they are here. And lots of you don't have Garden Warfare 1, and, you know, might not ever get the chance to play them yourselves or, you know, see any, like, explanations like this. So I figured this would be a really fun way to do it. So I hope you guys do enjoy this video so far. We still, of course, are only halfway done because we got to show off the other two characters. But there we go! The zombies win, but the zebra survives! Alright, so we're gonna start off with the Chester Chomper. And now this guy is pretty darn cool. He looks like a fun guy to hang out with. And if he looks familiar, because he is actually a part of a promotional deal with the Chester Cheetah, whatever it's called, the Cheetos, that's what they're called. So as you can see, I think I messed up. I think there should be one more ability that we don't have here. Let's see. Okay, that's not true. So you can see here that the Chester Chomper is not only its own original character, but he also has two exclusive moves, the Chester Goop, and he also has these little things right here. Now, I don't remember what's different about these, but they are different. They're orange and cheesy and sort of gross. I always find these kind of, you know, foods not really that delicious. But the big difference with the character itself is that it has a little bit less health, but it does digest a little bit faster. So that's sort of something you want to be running around and vanquishing as much as you can. Hello. Let's see if we can't find some zombies. I'm really bad at Chomper in this game, so chances are I'm gonna get beat up a lot and not do too well. But why this character was so unique, you know, beyond it being different from every other Chomper, of course, is the fact of how you could unlock it. First off, when it came to this and the Chester Cheetah Scientist, there was only one way you could unlock them at first when the event was going on, and that was to go out to a store, buy Garden Warfare branded Cheetos, and then there should be a code inside of the bag. You know, redeem the code, which you could do like, you can't do it here in the pause menu, but you can do it in the main menu. You can redeem that code, and then you would be able to get yourself both the Chester Cheetah Chomper and the Dr. Chester. So that was what you had to do to get these. You actually had to go out to a store and buy them. And I was so frustrated because they didn't have them in my area. I also don't like buying those kinds of foods and just like all that kind of stuff. So I actually wasn't able to get them because of that. But luckily, a few months, I think like about a month afterwards, they actually did release them for free. So it was just sort of like, what was the point? But like a month after, when the whole promotional campaign ended and you couldn't get the, you know, the Cheetos anywhere, they just gave them out for free. So let's go ahead and steal that Chomper's kill. I'm so sorry, but you know what? I gotta do it. So we're doing okay. We got three vanquishes. That isn't atrocious for how bad I am with Chompers. So that's pretty good. So I have max. That's not true. Yeah, that's not true at all. That was a weird glitch. But, okay, some of these I'm just not gonna be able to do. Like this one. I wanna skip that one. But either way, you get the idea. And the Chester Chomper is actually a very popular Chomper. And I don't know if there's really a Chomper that's similar to him in Garden Warfare 2. I mean, there are several new Chompers in Garden Warfare 2. There is the Yeti Chomper, which of course is not anything like the Cheetah Chomper because of course he has ranged attack. And then, let's get you. There you go. Oh, that was a good shot. That was a pretty good shot right there. You're certainly not too good with that. And it does some decent damage. 10 damage a tick is pretty good. Oh, he does not see me. Oh, you just made a mistake. Unless you just hop to the next staircase or rooftop or whatever it is. Oh, darn it. That one like skimmed you. Oh, well. But yeah, oh, there's another one. Hello. But yeah, there's also the Disco Chomper, which I don't think he is anything different from the normal Chomper beyond the fact that, of course, he can go into Disco Legendary mode, so that's his big difference. And then the Unicorn Chomper, which, of course, is significantly different, and we've already blabbed enough about him in these, you know, Garden Warfare 1 videos. So with that being said, you know, he's pretty unique. I don't really think he's been truly recreated in Garden Warfare 2. I think that it's not really needed, though. Like, to be honest, he's not that substantially different in Garden Warfare 1 to the other Chompers that it's, you know, like, exactly like, oh, we need him in Garden Warfare 2, you know? So if they never remake him, personally, I won't be too worried about it. I don't know, maybe you Chomper, you know, dedicated Chomper players, you can, you know, bark at me about it in the comment section and let me know that I'm entirely wrong and we need a Dr. Chomper, Chester Chomper, Cheetah, you know, equivalent. But I'm not really sure. Let's go ahead and let's destroy you if I can. Come on, let's sneak up, sneak up, sneak up. Bada boom. So we have, oh boy, about halfway through this game now. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and respawn and try to switch to the enemy side. And we're gonna go ahead and get started with the Dr. Chester. Now the Dr. Chester has been recreated in the most part in Garden Warfare 2 with, what's it called? The Zoologist. A lot of people compare him to the Zoologist. So do we have all the, yeah, we do have all the Chester Cheetah stuff on him. So he, you can see he actually has a collection of different cheetah related things. He has his, you know, cheetah throwing balls. He's got the poofy cheese teleport, which is like super fast, but you only get one of them. And actually that's a really cool teleport that has not made its way in to Garden Warfare 2, another thing. Oh, okay, Cheetah versus Cheetah. But you can see the whole thing with him is that he has a faster fire rate. It's not as much damage, but it's fast enough to get some decent damage out like that. And just really cool. I just love that so much. I think it is definitely a larger distance than your average teleport. I think the teleporting animation is a little bit faster as well. So that's all pretty cool stuff. If you're trying to escape or maybe even catch up with an enemy, definitely might be worth that choice. So definitely some things that the Dr. Chester has that Garden Warfare 2 doesn't have, but the character himself is basically recreated with Zoologist. I think that they sort of feel slightly different, but not entirely. Here, can we get you? Where are you, dude? Boom, 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 boom. But it's just that fast fire rate. You know, short range. Is he short ranged? Yeah, it looks like it. He can't like do any damage to that wall there. So you get the idea. He's very, very similar to the Zoologist. So let's hop on the mattress. Imagine if this was bouncy. That'd be so cool. Oh, wow. I can dream, can't I? But yeah, he's one of the characters that has been. So, you know, if you don't get the chance to play him here in Garden Warfare 1, you're not missing out on too much. Bada boom. Oh, wow. I think we did damage to him when we landed on him there. That's very interesting. Honestly, I never gave this guy too much of a chance outside of our one showcase of him back when he, you know, was released. Whoa, she did like a double backflip there. She's a gymnast. That was beautiful. 10 out of 10 landing. But these are all four of the characters that are not available in Garden Warfare 2. And I just think it's very novel. And I think it was definitely worth having like a dedicated video showing off all four of them. And one last thing I'll do is I'll actually go through and try to show you guys some of the plant pots and zombie bots that are not available in Garden Warfare 2 that are in Garden Warfare 1. Now, with that being said, there is a bit of a vice versa as well, in the fact that there are some Garden Warfare 2, stuff and that aren't in Garden Warfare 1. Of course, you know, there's zombots and spawnable, you know, plant weeds and everything that aren't in Garden Warfare 1. Like, that's just not even a feature, you know? So it's just interesting, you know, like, what's the difference between the two games and the similarities as well, you know? So that's always pretty cool. Like, one thing that I know is for sure, I was about to go to these to pick up heals. I'm still just so used to playing plants right now. But, one thing, is I know that the fire pea plant pot is not in Garden Warfare 2, but it is here in Garden Warfare 1. And what's weird is that physically it's in the game. There's actually a little quest where you can talk to a fire pea plant pot that explains that he's not actually a fire pea, he's just a normal pea shooter on fire. Now the fire pea variant is in Garden Warfare 2, but like the fire pea plant pot that you can spawn in is not. Even though he's physically in the game through that quest, you can't get him in any way, you can't spawn him. So I wonder if they'll ever bring on every single plant pot or, you know, spawnable zombie, or if they'll just keep it to what they have, who knows. Let's go ahead and try to get you. Come on, ooh, there you go, that wasn't bad. And I'm gonna run over this way, and there you go, we lost, hooray! All right, so we'll be right back, and I'll be trying to show off those differences, and then I'll be it for today. So we're here in Garden Ops, so I can go ahead and talk about this really quick before we finish off the video about some of the plant pots that are not in Garden Warfare 2 that are in Garden Warfare 1. I love this map so much, by the way. This is like one of my favorites in the entire game. One of the first rounds of Garden Ops I played in this map. It was so much fun. Let's go ahead and check out some of the ones that aren't. So believe it or not, the repeater is not in Garden Warfare 2. You have the normal pea cannon and you have the sentry, but you do not have the repeater. Now, besides that, we do have the Fume Shroom and Goof Shroom. We do have the Scaredy Shroom. We do have the Snapdragon. Really, what we don't see too much of is the Fire Pea. So really, the two we do not have are the Repeater and the Fire Pea. And of course, there is some holiday stuff here, like the Franken Shroom and the Cat Dragon, which we do not have. But those are just holiday stuff. There were other holiday stuff as well that I just don't happen to have. But you get the idea. And beyond that, there were only a handful of summonable zombies that weren't actually in Garden Warfare 2. They actually brought most of those over. But the ones they didn't bring in is, I don't think they brought in the Conehead. And I don't think they brought in the Exploding Imp. But I might be, I think they changed the Exploding Imp is the thing. In Garden Warfare 1, he's sort of like rolling around on a little bomb. But in Garden Warfare 2, he is more of like the imp-punted imp, where he's holding like little, you know, like foam fingers and he's running around and he'll just explode when he reaches you. I think that they don't have every pirate. Like, I don't know. Okay, there's the map pirate and the barrel pirate in this game that you can spawn in, but I don't think that those two are available. Yeah, I'm almost positive those two are not available in Garden Warfare 2. And then the vampire zombie is definitely in GW2. And then, so I think the only thing beyond that is that the summonable turkey brown coat, which was for a Thanksgiving event in Garden Warfare 1. We haven't had a formal Thanksgiving event in Garden Warfare 2 yet. Even though Thanksgiving has passed, we didn't actually do anything for that one. So we don't have that. And then the holiday brown coat is in Garden Warfare 2, but it is significantly different. Like, it has like actual flashing lights. So it has like different levels of detail, but that's about it. That's almost everything I can find that's pretty cool in Garden Warfare 1 that you won't find in Garden Warfare 2, except for, you know, like every map in the game, but maybe that's for a different video. But with that being said, we're gonna go ahead and finish off for today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you want to see more Garden Warfare 1 related content like this, let me know in the comment section below. But for now, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, make sure to give this video a like, share it with your friends and family, and of course, comment in the comment section below. If you watch this point of the video, make sure you comment Barry Zebra so I know you've watched it in the video and that you are a Zebratastic viewer. But either way, thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.